and gentlemen, Gungans and Troys, across our beloved empire, welcome to Arnold Hollinet News, the only news you'll ever need. Because you have no other choice, but it's the people's choice, let me tell you. And today, it's going to be quite a busy day, because it is certainly great to be in this empire today. And speaking of empire, we have a full kit reveal for Mara Jade. And if you put your money down that Mara Jade is supposed to help out Jedi Knight Luke Skywalker, nah, she's helping out her first favorite man with the plan, Emperor Palpatine. Yes, indeed. She is going to have some Imperial synergies, and it's supposed to be a direct call out to her time as the Emperor's hand with Emperor Palpatine. So let's go ahead and bring you on over all this news. Today is coming from Operation Metaverse's exclusive interview. There will be a link down below in the video description. It's going to be a busy day. We're going to have multiple uploads, some other big stuff happening. As we speak right now, they did a little developer interview. They got the kit reveal and they got some developer inspiration. So feel free to listen to it. But I did write up the full kit reveal in case you do not have time to listen to the full entire podcast, because they don't show any text. You kind of have to listen to get the kit reveal. But nonetheless, it's a good listen. Anyways, Mara Jade, the Emperor's Hand, Dark Side Attacker, Empire, Unaligned Force User, not a Sith based character, although she is going to boost Sith characters on the team, as we're going to see highlights here. Before we get into it, we got the Emperor's Hand directly boosts Emperor Palpatine, and Mara Jade uses her allies as pawns when Emperor Palpatine is not present, and it's great. So the developers, they kind of designed Mara Jade with the mindset of when she's with Emperor Palpatine, they're getting tons of bonuses. The turn meter train is going to be insane. She looks like she's going to be a territory war killer as well. And in this situation, you don't want to use her Emperor Palpatine for whatever reason. She's getting a variety of movesets, kind of like when she's out on the battlefield executing Palpatine's orders and his grand plan. And then we got to talk about this. Infiltrator and Assassin spreads crippling debuffs for her team and stacks impressive damage to finish off enemies. So notice they didn't say high single fire damage this time. Now it's impressive damage with it all. And before we get into the kit reveal, the full kit breakdown, I think this character might have low star viability, especially if you have the Omicron in her. Developers did say, by the way, moving forward, the plan is every new character is going to have an Omicron. So I recommend at least waiting and seeing what the rest looks like before the Grand Arena sign-up phases starts up later on this week or next week. And she's going to keep the turn meter train flowing strong in an Emperor Palpatine lineup. And I think Darth Vader as well is getting a huge, significant boost in viability with Mara Jade, because he's a little bit lackluster nowadays. But nonetheless, let's go ahead and break down this kit reveal. Hopefully it's legible for you guys. If not, that's what my Imperial voice is all about here. So, as we said, she boosts Emperor Palpatine, but not Sith. She can't be used outside of Palpatine, but can be with or without him. Useful Pawn is a new effect that acts both as a debuff for her allies, but a buff for her, and Loyal Hand only activates when Emperor Palpatine's present. Every time they're taking turns, she's increasing her max protection as well as the offense here. Stats, they didn't go into nitty-gritties, but they said she's supposed to be high offense and high speed, and she's gonna take tons of turns to help Palpatine, and especially if you got that Omicron, which is a TW, Territory War exclusive Omicron, she's gonna start with 100% turn meter, and the only character that should be able to outrun her, I'm guessing Wat Tambor, and more importantly, Han Solo. Han always shoots first in Galaxy Zero. So the basic is called Calculated Shot. Special damage to target enemy and inflict daze for two turns. Then she's going to attack again. A daze on a basic. Mwah! Stopping counterattack, stopping turn meter on the opposing team. But if Palpatine is a leader, he assists if it's Mara Jade's turn. Otherwise, if Palpatine is not in the leader, a random ally with useful pawn assists, dealing 50% damage. No matter with or without Palpatine, as long as there's some dark side unit on the field, she's going to be able to get everyone to assist. Now, do note, she doesn't have a leader, but when she has useful, when she gives useful pawn to everyone, she kind of acts like a leader. She's going to be calling people to assist, but it's really that daze that I'm really liking. And they're going to address one of my main concerns of Palpatine Invader, and that's being able to apply the debuffs. If you can't apply the debuff, the turn meter train does not roll. And we have a lot of teams that have tenacity up that start at the very beginning, or crazy high built-in tenacity, for example, like Jolie Bindo or the Bastlashan Jedi Leader. And here's where it comes in handy. Ultimate Predator, her first special ability. We don't have cooldown numbers from this developer interview, but nonetheless, we gotta read what it's all about. Dispel buffs and inflict stun for one turn on the target enemy. But wait, there's more. Then inflict special damage on all enemies and inflict tenacity down, an AoE tenacity down. To my recollection, that is the only character in Galaxy that has an AoE, area of effect, attack on everyone, whatever you want to call it, tenacity down. And once you open up that gateway for debuffs, that's going to help them flow that turn meter, and you might get left behind in the dust. And keep in mind, this isn't even looking at the territory war Omicron yet. And then shocked enemies and Jedi take double damage from this ability, which is kind of a big call out to how Palpatine's kit works, because he realizes anti-Jedi, anti-Rebel, anti-shock capabilities. It's really going to compound on top of things like Crackling Doom, for example. We're going to do a little recap on Palpatine in a moment. Second special, Infiltrate and Disrupt. And this is probably going to be the big ability. It's weird. You kind of want to maybe, you think you want to open up with Tenacity down first, but there might be good reason to open up with this, especially once we get to that Omicron later on here. Infiltrate and Disrupt deal special damage to all enemies. Two AoE specials. Only other character that might have that is General Anakin Skywalker with two AoE specials inside a Galaxy of Heroes. Deal special damage to all enemy and inflict offense down, shock, and stagger on all enemies for two turns. Mara Jade gains stealth for two turns and 1.25% terminator for each debuff inflicted by this ability. And if Emperor Palpatine is the leader, he also gains 1.25% terminator for each debuff inflicted on this ability. Holy cow. Now keep in mind, if you're gonna run Emperor of the Galactic Empire, anytime an Imperial ally is already inflicting a debuff during their turn, they're gaining 20% turn meter. With this, just looking at the Infiltrate and Disrupt, it's looking like she can get about 15% turn meter from this. Added to the Emperor of Galactic Empire, oh my goodness, she is gonna run some pretty serious circles around the team. And the fact that she can feed Emperor Palpatine this turn meter as well is crazy. But look at this, if you can get her to start off first and get the stagger on all enemies. Now keep in mind, I don't recall them saying it can't be resisted, so the stagger can perhaps be resisted still. But if you can get everyone to hit the stagger, or apply the stagger, and then you get Palpatine to get tons of terminator, Palpatine can follow up right away and open up with his AoE, Power of the Dark Side, hit everyone with that and pull back terminator, and then all of a sudden your train starts chugga 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 chugga. It's just gonna keep on rolling. The Palpatine Express might be back in business. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unique ability, and it's a long one, that has a Territory War Omicron associated with it. If Palpatine is the leader at the start of the encounter, Empire and Sith allies gain 20% offense and potency. Isn't there somewhere else that has a something that addresses potency? Yes! Emperor Palpatine's lead, Emperor of the Galactic Empire, Empire and Sith allies are getting 35% potency and 35% max health. So I mentioned that stagger, there is a chance it could be resisted. With the 35% potency from the Emperor of the Galactic Empire, which is likely going to be her core home, as well as getting the 20% potency boost associated with the Emperor's hand, that 50 plus some potency should be adequate to get these debuffs applying. And if you get debuffs applying, the turn meter train should start rolling for your team. But we're not done yet, kiddo. Otherwise, all dark side allies gain a useful pawn, a new effect in the game as we'll break down. And at the start of Mara Jade's and Palpatine's turn, Mara Jade gains a stack of loyal hand. And I think this is kind of a funny little call out right here, if you guys can't see it. If Jedi Knight Luke Skywalker is on the enemy team, Mara Jade inflicts blind on him for one turn at the start of her turn. A nice little call out to how Jedi Knight Luke came across Mara Jade and was absolutely blind with love, or however you want to put it. So not going to be helpful for the AoE stun, but it's going to be helpful to at least avoid the basic attack, try to evade it, which is a decent hitting ability. That's why they said in the interview they didn't give her foresight, because Jedi Luke Skywalker can eat through foresight. Blind is a little bit more helpful in that situation. Omicron for Territory Wars, and this is where things can get pretty nuts. I was kind of hoping this would have been for Grand Arena, because Qui-Gon Jinn looks like he might be a serious threat. And it would have been nice having this to maybe outrun those Jedi teams out there. Omicron for Territory Wars. If she's in Territory, she starts with 100% Terminator. It sounds like basically you're going to need Han Solo to stop her in her place before she can do something. Because if she opens up with Infiltrate and Disrupt, gets the stagger, gets all the debuffs, feeds the Terminator to herself, as well as Palpatine, this can get nasty really quickly. At the start of each of the encounter, ignore the misspelling right there. I'm starting to look like a developer writing up a kit post. remove the enemy leader's protection. What is that? Okay, hold on. she's going to remove the enemy leader's protection at the start of the encounter and reduce their max protection by 50%, which does not affect Galactic Legends. She can possibly be, again, how something looks on paper is different from how it works, as we kind of saw with Darth Talon. But on paper, it sounds like, kind of like how Sith Eternal just makes General Anakin Skywalker take a knee. It sounds like if she has a territory Omicron, she's going to cripple gas and make him knee down, or kneel down. Thank you, Gary, for fixing the teleprompter. Kneel down immediately. And they just got to wait until all the 501st clones get killed off. Then he stands back up. So that is going to be nasty. And when he does stand back up, he only has 50% max protection left on him. Whenever an enemy unit dies, inflict vulnerable, which cannot be resisted for two turns on a random enemy, and allies gain 20% max protection. Now, this is going to be great. Emperor Palpatine's lead does max health bonuses. You get 35% max health, as we saw. But if you come back over here really quick, there are some characters that would really enjoy having some max protection on them. Stormtrooper, for example, gets bonus protection at the start of his turn through Wall of Stormtroopers. A more durable tank is a great thing to have. Grand Admiral Thrawn! I love his little lead, legendary strategist. Kind of the inverse, he has to get status effects to gain Terminator, unlike Palpatine's more of you have to apply status effects to gain Terminator. But with the Palpatine's elite here, there's tons of extra protection inside of the Grand Admiral Thrawn team. So it's going to be a little bit more durable. If a team, if you get I sometimes call her Bassa Shan Fallen, because in practice, she kind of reminds me of how Bassa Shan has been helpful for Emperor Palpatine, because she applies all these debuffs and keeps the turn meter train rolling for the Emperor of the Galactic Empire. If you're going to pair these things together, Bassa Shan Fallen, Darth Vader, Mara Jade, if you don't find a way to get a daze on these guys right away, maybe Dash Rendar might be helpful if you could somehow outrun them. But there's a territory Omicron you're not going to be able to outrun. Or you're going to need to get Han Solo into the team here. It's going to get very interesting how this operates. Now, lastly, you might be asking, what does useful pawn do? We kind of alluded to it earlier, but it's going to debuff all the other dark side units by 5% critical chance, critical damage, and offense. For each of them, Mara Jade gains 10% of those stats. Now, keep in mind, this only activates if there is no Emperor Palpatine in the leadership. When Palpatine's not in the team, well, then this triggers. When Palpatine is in the leader position, you're going to gain Loyal Hand, 10% max protection, and max offense for each stack. So, hypothetically, she should be pretty dang durable. I don't want to say high single fire damage, but it sounds like maybe one of those things over the course of the battle where one of the problems with Dark Talon that we experience is that she needs to quickly get her own Dark Frenzy going over and over and over again. So it takes a bit of it's a lot more time. In a 5-minute battle, we only got 16, and she couldn't do crazy amounts of damage as well. Here, at least, if you're getting tons of Terminator with Palpatine and Mara Jade, as long as Mara Jade and Palpatine are taking their turn, she's gonna get a stack of Loyal Hands. So it sounds like on paper, she should get more Loyal Hands than the situation of Darth Talon that we had, and that hopefully will translate into a very durable Mara Jade, maybe even at low stars, and more importantly, getting that offense up and running. And honestly, even depending on, it depends what team you're going to use, but 5% critical chance, critical damage, and offense isn't really, it's not really a lot to give away for her to get something back. So you're probably not even going to notice that minor little deficiency, especially when, depending on what teams you throw in, they might increase those stats. So it's not a bad trade-off whatsoever. Yeah, it's slightly debuffing the team, but in the end, she's gaining quite a lot of stuff. Overall, looking forward to how this character is going to operate this guy. I know Darth Talon's been the more lackluster marquee character we've gotten out of this class. Probably will have its use more down the road when things come to light. But I like how these marquee characters, this is the final requirement for Starkiller. Starkiller's coming out December 15th. I like how each and every one of these characters are meant to address a team that is a bit underappreciated and can actually use the help. Dash Rendar, fantastic scoundrels. Kyle Katarn's doing wonders for the Rebel fighters. Darth Talon, I think there's going to be more down the road, especially with that leak that we saw a while ago. Mara Jade is going to help out Palpatine and Vader. I have not used Palpatine and Vader in a top-end Grand Arena in ages because it's just not that useful for me. This might help it put it back on the map a little bit. So, ladies and gentlemen, go and get the droids. Ha! That's going to wrap it up for today. Thank you so much for stopping by. Leave a like, comment down below, and all your thoughts. I assume this character is going to be here on Thursday. So if you want to get an Imperial's perspective of this, feel free to come by Thursday. Hope to see you all there. Stay tuned for more videos, most likely later on today. And on top of all that, always remember, baby, it's great to be in the Empire today.
We'll be right back.